We are a group of researchers from the MRC Centre for Regenerative Medicine, and what we're doing is we're providing a mentoring scheme for high school students from the local high school around the corner, Castlebrae High.
The mentoring scheme was all down to the sort of passion and enthusiasm of Sabine and also the teacher Thomas Lindsay at the school. We wanted to develop the relationships between ourselves and the community. And so we arranged for the pupils to come on a visit.
The students came over and they had a day here to see the work of a scientist, get a bit of a flavour what an actual scientist does, and how what they learn in school actually might translate into a job in science further down the line.
Sabine approached me after the young people had visited, and it was like a light bulb moment she'd had.
I mean, the actual beginning of the story is that I cycle in every morning past the high school and I knew that we had ties to the high school already, and I think having the proximity to the school really helps with that as well.
The project is quite a complicated thing, but at its core it is a partnership between Castlebrae Community High School and the Centre for Regenerative Medicine at Little France. Or the biggest part of that has been having mentors from the CRM come in here every couple of weeks and support our students in either support study, doing their coursework, or how to do particular practical work, and hopefully over the year boosting their confidence.
I feel like I've become better at it. Like, I found science hard at first, but I really enjoy it now.
The real thing at CRM and Edinburgh University have offered that the school can is insight into what real science actually looks like. The mentors have been quite honest with them. They've told them all the trials and tribulations of trying to do practical science and the fact that you have to go in at the weekends and sometimes your cells die or your experiment you've been working on for 6 months just completely fails, and it's kind of par for the course.
The idea in the beginning was just to provide like a buddy system to the students, just so they have a buddy along their side that they can actually turn to, which is not necessarily their teacher or their families.
They'll talk to you about anything. So like if you wanted to speak maybe about something that was other than science, they would happily do that.
We're actually a really international bunch of people. In the countries that we're coming from, we also struggled, like going to university, getting to where we are, and I think that's something that we wanted to show them as well.
The school and also the community are our neighbours. We are part of that landscape. We're connected with them. And so I guess in a way the benefits to us are feeling part of a community, and that our work reflects the needs of that community. Part of the success of the scheme has been that it's come from the researchers themselves rather than, say for example, the science communicators at the centre.
The best we could hope for is that the students get out of this and they somehow feel strengthened and feel as if they have a perspective and they know how to work to get where they want to get. And that's basically what I'd like to see from it.
It has helped me come to a decision when I leave school that I would want to work in the labs.
What I find amazing is that every researcher involved in the project is dedicating their personal time to it. It's not only that the students can learn from us or can turn to us, but it's also that we really broaden our perspective and that we learn a lot from them. Namely that we are quite privileged in our educational system, and that it's sort of our duty to pass on that privilege to others.